Hello everyone, thanks for sharing my content and thanks for really encouraging me. I did a survey the other day and many of you wanted more information on technology and I'm doing this one just for you. I want to talk about technology, how it's changing our world. The way we interact will consistently change and is going to change even further with the metaverse coming on. Our digital footprint will be online forever, so be careful. Careful of what you text, what you post, and so forth. Just a word of caution. I want to highlight how facial recognition software is being used in the classroom. The key question is, should this technology be used in learning spaces? And what are the potential value and ethical issues for using such software? A few years ago, I visited a military conference. And I'm sure you know that within a military conference, they're going to have some sections that are public for the public viewing and other sections that are not. And as a matter of fact, for the disclaimer, I attended the section that was for the public. They showed various technologies and these technologies were based on simulation and military training. One technology that got me really attentive was the facial recognition software in conjunction with real biometric data. The algorithm used could combine the heartbeat, the blood pressure, eye movement, facial movements to establish whether or not the pilot was experiencing anxiety or other emotions. And of course, this will be connected to decision making. While I understand the need for this form of training, I did not imagine that this technology would be part of the education system within another 5 years. It's here. Schools are using facial recognition software in the classroom. Back in my time, a teacher could tell, even with their backs turned, that something was going on. I have been in a classroom when someone opens a suite or something and I could say, "Mary at the back, stop it." And they would say, "How do you know?" "Yeah, I know. I saw Mary moving a bit suspiciously. And then I turned my back and then I heard the rapper. So I took that plus that to understand where Mary was sitting and I called the name." So many times I've done that. A trained teacher in my time, and I'm sure our time still, could tell who was focused or the student in need of help. As a matter of fact, if I looked at a student who looked puzzled, I could ask two questions to see where the student was. Yes, I could do that. Teachers can really tell in real time what's going on. Well, now a school in China now uses machine learning in the form of facial recognition to track and analyze how students behave and react to teachers in real time. Yes, in real time. In the classroom, the teacher could use facial recognition software to identify students who are engaged, calm, happy, disgusted, or sometimes fearful. Yes, there are some possibilities with the machine. However, I just stated that it's not there yet. The software could also identify students who raise their hands. And of course, this information could be tabulated and cross-referenced to the students who are more engaged. A facial recognition system can analyze students' behavior and their engagement in real time, as I stated earlier. However, we must ensure that we check these technology companies out in greater detail to ensure that they do not enter the game just for profit, but to contribute to the movement of education. And as a matter of fact, we should not let them loose on our education sector without proper evaluation. Today's facial recognition software has major faults and could reproduce inequality in our society. I have a few thoughts that I would like to close with. When you talk about this software, have we considered the issue of data protection and data protection laws? Do our countries have specific laws that will regulate such technology? Or are we still using data protection laws that are dated? What about privacy issues? How will we address them? What if there are some children who are going through life-changing events and actually commit an offense that can be deemed as criminal. How will the system address that? Just imagine the consequence of using such a system in a country like America that arrests thousands of young children. Let me also say that we cannot allow an imperfect system, because these algorithms are not perfect, to evaluate our children using only data sets. I disagree, because let me say that all children learn differently. No child is the same. In addition, we cannot allow the normalization of surveillance to be taking place in our schools. There must be some limitations. Notwithstanding, I do see a space as it relates to security that surveillance can take place. But within the classroom social environment aspect, I have a problem with that. I want to also say that we should never force families or children to participate in this level of surveillance. No, we should not allow that. However, you should consider if the issue is ensuring the safety and protection of children. We should never force families to participate in this level of surveillance. If there is a need, we should ensure that it is justified for safety reasons or life-threatening events. Let me sum up by saying, while there are some potential benefits in using facial recognition software, I think we must consider the learning spaces that children will engage in. You should not bring technology into the system that is biased, unreliable, and underdeveloped. I think it must be developed correctly. Furthermore, teachers should be equipped to have a general feeling of what each student will need in their class. It is my belief that within the context of knowing, teachers must have social presence, emotional presence, as they connect with their students. This social presence and emotional presence is not available via facial algorithms. It's available by physical presence, the teacher being there. And I realize that these technology companies, they want to create the issue of presence. You cannot recreate physical presence as it relates to a human being. They are two different things. And if we do not understand that, the pathway that we're going is going to be very problematic. Because, to be honest, I want my child to be able to understand the real world. That's all for now, and that's my final thought.